Welcome to the finals of the League of Legends Salt City Tournament. It's going to be a best of five to make sure that we have the best players coming out on top.
Best.
We have Sushi Man versus Soundside.
Yeah, I mean, Soundside, best player on his side of the bracket.
Not sure what you're implying.
Nothing.
Okay.
Whatsoever.
Okay, so let's go through their bans. Sushi, of course, banned the classic I don't give a fuck bans, which is Aatrox, Ahri, Akali.
The AAA bans. And then Soundside banned out a couple of top lane characters because that's Sushi Man's favorite.
Yep.
All 25,000 of them.
Yep.
So he banned out Gnar, Darius, and Zed. Which isn't totally gonna help, because Sushi Man still has Jace, he still has Yasuo, he still has Riven, he still has Fizz, he still has pretty much anyone that's top lane.
Or listen,
has ever been top lane official.
Anything could happen.
Man, I was really hoping that Soundside was gonna throw out that AP Warwick round one.
The AP Warwick? Yeah.
Ooh! Sushi not playing a bruiser.
No, he's doing the long range caster.
I was not expecting this from him. I was expecting him to go same thing playing for pretty much the rest of the tournament, where he was playing, you know, bruisers, melee champs.
You know, I think he did Vel'Koz in the semifinals.
Did he? I mean, I cast that, I should probably remember. But yeah.
I mean, I know he played Vel'Koz in one of his games.
The Jax isn't terrible against Vel'Koz, because he does have his leap in, but once he leaps in, all Sushi has to do is blow his W at his own feet to knock him up, and then get the wave off, get the Q off, and there's your true damage, so it's not going to be easy.
No, it certainly won't be. I don't know. It's going to be rough.
Yeah, I think it's going to be real rough for Soundside.
He's going to have to try and get in whatever CS he can, and probably is going to need to all in pre-level 6.
Well, the bad part about it is Vel'Koz pretty much doesn't rely on any auto-attacks, unless he's trying to keep his stack on while he's waiting for cooldowns.
Right.
So that really doesn't make Jax's W all that great. So I hope he actually uses his dodge against creeps, so that when he goes for the all-in, he's not getting chunked out by the creeps as well as Vel'Koz.
Well, he'd probably use it more for just the stun to like get as much damage as possible, but yeah, I don't know. He's going to have to all-in pre-level 6, because I don't think after level 6 he'll be able to get the kill.
Oh, definitely not. After level 6, I feel like it's all over. Well, I mean, I feel the whole game's in Sushi Man's favor, but really, at the level 6, he doesn't even have to use his ult to get the kill, he just has to use his ult to keep Soundside low and keep him away from the creep wave.
Right. We'll see. It's gonna be a game of balls and outplaying.
Balls and outplaying. Balls splitting into more balls and keeping you off your own relic.
Yes.
Because, you know, pressure. I don't know. I mean, I like the fact that he's taking the exhaust, but I think he was taking that more because he thought he was going to actually be dueling.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas the flash would be a little bit handy for that.
To catch onto the Vel'Koz, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see. If he can get the leap stun W with Ignite, he might be able to chunk him down early enough that he could get some good CS in, and then maybe he can get another leap in afterwards to finish it.
Well, and maybe he plays the wave really well and plays it sort of, you know, unorthodox, where he's not using the W for the stun and he is just using it to try to get the creep wave pushing. We'll see.
We will see. Let's see if any of them have any skins or if they're going solo.
I'm going to guess Warden Jax and Arclight Vel'Koz. Calling it? But we'll see.
Let's see, what do we got?
Boom!
Wow. Two for two.
I'm actually really happy.
That's really impressive. We don't... So that's one win for Mike.
Boom.
We need to have them remake this game.
1-0 skin calls.
Because you just won the skin call.
Are they crazy?
Velkoz is easy because he has like two
like
skins. But how did you get Jax?
I don't know. Especially Warden Jax. I was thinking like maybe he'd do Angler or like the Chinese with the giant the ball necklace one.
Yeah.
I forget what it's called. But yeah, he went Warden.
Alright. Well, we're in game now, so let's see.
I'm going to chalk that one up to my ultimate game knowledge.
Yeah, of course. So, Soundside going for the new Guardian's Hammer. Newish, I guess. And Boots and Three Pots. Ooh, Sushi's going for Chalice and Corrupting Potion. Interesting. I guess he's just really expecting to hang back and get pokes off.
Yeah, he must be really, really...
But I think he's going to get jumped on right now. Oh, he should have just gone for it. Just jump on him. He has no damage with...
Oof.
Oh, nice.
But
and
there
he
you
dodged.
Go. That was the... Trying to throw the pop right at his feet when Jax jumped
yep,
in.
Nope, that was excellent start. Excellent start. Let's see if he can keep it up or not. Because now that he's gone... Chalice, he really has like no power, and
no, he has to rely on just throwing out those little waves and not getting stunned. I mean, he has good return damage when the Jax is trying to walk away.
Yeah, but he's super squish.
Yeah, and I think one wave isn't doing much right now.
I think one more all in, and Soundside might be able to. He's got to control the wave a little better. He's got to have the wave push back to him so he can fully all in and not worry about the tower.
I mean, he's definitely got the runes and masteries for this matchup since Sushi actually did go more of the poke build than an actual combat build. So I mean, he's got tanky runes and masteries on. So all right,
he's got to burn the flash. Oh, that's really good combo there.
And that's what's gonna hurt because
as soon as
starts getting more levels, those are gonna be more and more and more.
Yeah, absolutely. But the nice thing is Soundside's got the advantage now with having pots available. And
that Guardian's Hammer is actually doing a lot more than I was thinking it was going to.
Oh yeah, that's nice.
Sustaining him back up pretty well. If he could ever dodge a Q.
I mean, he's touched a couple, but you're right, he's not doing a great job at it right now. He needs to pop his potions, I think, and just go for the all-in. Especially since Sushi doesn't have...
Well, he's down on HP now, and he really doesn't have... He's not going to have many rotations where the skill's left on his mana.
I guess he's thinking he can beat him at 6. I don't know if I... Well...
If you stun the...
If he stuns him in the ult, yeah.
Yeah. I'm actually surprised how close the CS is as well. I mean,
neither of them are really focusing on the CS at all.
Jax has been putting on good pressure, keeping the Vel'Koz more away from the wave than I thought he was going to. And so...
No, Vel'Koz hits 6. But he can't kill him yet. With both of them 6 and the wave pushing, this is the perfect time for Soundside right now. He's got good mana, he's got good health. If he goes in right now, Sushi has no flash to get away. I think he can win if he just goes in right now.
Yeah, I'm surprised he's not going into the bush.
He really, especially after just missing those two, he just missed both those skills.
He just blew two cooldowns, yeah.
Oh, this might be it. Ignite? Oh, not quite.
Did he blow his ultimate? Yes, he did.
No. Oh, Soundside? Yes, Soundside didn't ult.
Yeah.
I think he's still got a good amount, good advantage. I think he can still just jump. Now what he's got to do, he's just got to jump on Sushi.
And only
Counter-Strike if he sees him start to channel his ult.
Yeah,
But yeah, he's got a real good power spike right now.
Well, and Sushi's Runes, he's only got 15 AP passively. He didn't build any AP items, so he's really not putting out as much damage as
he he's not going to be putting out any damage. See, every time Sushi walks up, Soundside should be just doing WQ. Just WQ. Just keep up that harass. Because he's doing a really good job of dodging the skill shots at the moment. Like, he's dodged a good chunk. He busted that out a little early with his E, but...
Well, he's got his ultimate coming up in about 8 seconds, so... On the next go-in, he's going to have his Grandmasters back up.
But Sushi has his Flash back up.
And still has his Ignite.
Mm-hmm.
Every one of those hurts, though. Oof.
Yeah, yeah. But Sushi really doesn't have any sustain. He's got to just chill kind of in the back here. Soundside's doing a good job. He's got a nice CS lead. He could win this in just CS lead if this keeps going on.
He's ahead, yeah. And really, that Guardian's Hammer, it's doing so much more than I was thinking it was going to.
The sustain on that's really nice. Oh, get out of there. You can't Counter-Strike...
He tried.
Spells. You can't... You're right, he did try, but it doesn't change the fact that you can't do it.
I think it was just a panic button press. I think he meant to hop to a creep.
It's very possible.
I think he was trying to hop to a creep and he hit the wrong button because he saw him do the hop a little bit late.
Yeah. Well, he's still in a good situation. He doesn't have Ignite anymore, but he has
they both just came back up.
Oh, he could have gone for that for the kill. Now he's got to play safe. Or get... Oh, there it is. Exhaust Ignite. Oh, the Flash.
He didn't use Exhaust. I think he's going to die for it.
Oh, my God. Oh, that was so close.
That was a fantastic match.
Oh, my God. They both, like, died the last... Wait, who died first?
I'm pretty sure... Yeah. Jax got the first blood. Jax got first blood.
I'm going back real quick.
Jax has drawn first blood. Right on the screen.
Oh, shit.
That was fantastic.
Wow, that was amazing. Goddamn directional camera. That was pretty good. All right, that's the end of game one of our best of five in the finals. Let's run it back, see what happens in game two. Welcome to game two of the finals after an exciting game one match.
Fantastic.
Explosive, some might say.
I mean, I thought Jax lost. The screen said he won.
It was very confusing. So, they changed their bans up a little bit. Sushi did the reverse I don't care and went Zyra, Zillion, Ziggs.
The ZZZ, because he's going to sleep on this
correct.
Sound side.
Yes. And Soundside just updated his to do Gnar and Darius like last time, but changed it up to Vel'Koz this time because he didn't want to do Vel'Koz again.
He does not want to play that crap again at all.
No, he does not, even though he won, which is weird. You think he wouldn't care if he won? I guess it doesn't matter.
Vel'Koz is one of those characters where I hate being in lane against them.
But I think he had the advantage the majority of that game.
Oh, and we already got quick lock-in, so it's nice. Going to be pocket pick Malzahar for Soundside and a pocket pick Riven for Sushi Man.
How is it a pocket pick for Sushi Man? You don't know if that's what Sushi Man likes to play.
I've checked his match history.
No, you haven't.
I will go bring up.
See, I just know you're a dirty liar.
Do you hear the frustrating typing?
It's not going to change the sound of your lies.
So, how do you think the match is actually going to go, though? I feel like
it's
sort of flipped. Now the lane pressure
is completely flipped. It's definitely AP pressure versus Bruiser, the exact opposite. I do think, though, that Soundside still has a pretty good chance because of the spell shield that Malzahar gets passively.
Oh, I forgot about the new spell shield.
So that's gonna really help him not get CC locked by the Riven.
that's definitely going to help, because depending on how the Riven actually lands for damage,
yeah.
So that might block the stun every time.
Exactly. So if it'll either block the stun or a knockup, I think. So I think if Soundside plays well and plays within his minions, I think he'll actually be in a pretty safe spot, and he'll just be able to auto-push in Sushi. So he has a pretty good chance of actually taking first tower. Which I'd like to see. That game got dangerously close to... The last game got dangerously close to first to 100 CS. I'd still like to see one of those.
They got a lot further up there than I thought they were going to.
Yeah.
And really all that takes is someone playing like probably how Malzahar is going to play this game. Pretty passive, pretty defensive. Really don't want to be anywhere near that Riven.
Right. So what I'm predicting is going to happen is Sushi's going to get annoyed about halfway through this match and when and just flash an all-in Soundside at level 6. And then he'll either get the kill or he won't. That's what I predict.
Yeah, I mean, I think, yeah, it's going to be a flash engage from the Riven. She's going to pop everything, do as much damage as she can, and expect to burst somehow. Mm-hmm.
You think you're going to get the skins right this time?
Oh, definitely. It's going to be Sultan Malzahar against Arcade Riven. Or Battle Bunny. Ooh.
Don't do or. You got to commit!
I'll go with Arcade. It was my first choice.
Okay.
But if I'm wrong, just know that I said Battle Bunny for the backup.
Alright. I think you're right.
Even though it'll probably be champion.
I think you're right about Sultan or Sultan Malzahar. Don't know about Riven.
Oh, it's definitely Sultan Malzahar. I mean, Malzahar's only got, like, what, 6 skins?
Yeah.
And the coolest one being Sultan.
Well, we'll see if you're right again. If you get it right again, I don't even know what I'm going to do.
I mean, I want to go 3 for 3.
I'll walk away and I'll just let you self-cast.
I want to go first 3 for 3. That's what I'm hoping for. Come on. Oh, no!
Oh, half
he
right.
He didn't do Sultan!
You forgot that he likes Shadow Prince.
Oh!
So close.
I was so close.
I was about to get up and leave the casting.
Well, I'm 3 for 4. I tried my best. I cast as well as I could.
All right, so Sushi going for the early all-in damage with the 3.
Steeps. No sustain.
Yeah.
Doesn't want a Guardian Hammer anything, and Soundside going for the exact opposite build.
Yeah.
He wants to be able to sustain.
I think the Guardian Orb's good, and I know Soundside's not going to go anywhere near that bush.
Oh, no, he's a total wuss.
He's going to stay as far away from it as possible.
Let's rephrase that. If he's smart, he won't go anywhere near that bush. So there's still the opportunity of him walking into that damn thing.
That's true. Let's see.
Also,
you think
Sushi Man
gonna go for
played
the
Riven for 21% of Season 3 and 4 and 35% of Season 2. Boo.
So 3 years ago he liked to play Riven?
No, for 3 years he played Riven.
20% is not a lot.
Of your ranked matches?
That's not a lot.
Fine. Whatever.
Is he going to do just the immediate all-in? See, there's the one, like, block the one thing. That's what I'm saying. He would have been better off staying in his minions. He would have...
Ooh. Did he triple level the W? Double level the W?
I don't know. I didn't see. What is it? What has he got? No. Well, he already
Man, that does
lost,
a lot of damage already.
But that was pretty good. A pretty good start. Sushi's already burned his pots. He's got nothing else for his pots. Oh, there's that. I think he's dead.
Oh, snap!
Yeah.
Brutal.
Oh, well, that one was pretty quick, unfortunately. But, yeah, I guess that's kind of what we said was going to happen. So she was going to flash in and just go on him immediately.
Yeah, and I mean, that was really how he had to play it. With how much damage he got chunked out by the Malzahar, he really couldn't afford to let another stack of that void get onto him.
Yeah. Well, Well, that's the end of game two. That one much faster and a little more one-sided than the previous round. We'll see what happens in game three. Okay, welcome to game three. Right now we're all tied up 1-1 with Soundside taking the first game and Sushi Man taking the second game.
Yeah, I'm really glad that we've got an even match headed into game three, so it's not really a deciding factor. It's just right. I'm hoping we make it to five. I really like when best of fives go all the way to the fifth game.
Yep, that makes it more exciting for everyone involved. I agree.
And really quick lock-ins again. We got Sushi Man playing more of the lane pressure and Soundside back to the Bruiser. So they're going to keep switching every match.
I think he's going to go for full AP Assassin, though.
On the Fizz?
Yep.
I mean, maybe once he sees what Sushi's playing?
I mean, you really can't change after you select for the...
Yeah, it is ARAM, so he's probably going to go with the full AP.
As for bans, Sushi Man switched it back to the original beginning, Aatrox, Ahri, Akali.
The Class A don't care.
Yeah, and Soundside switched his up a little bit to be Gnar still, but he changed to get rid of Riven and Rumble. I think he's just going to automatically ban whatever Sushi Man just last played.
And I think the only reason he banned out the Rumble is because he knew he wanted to play Fizz next.
Yeah, that's probably...
And the Rumble is really good against a Fizz.
Yeah. Plus, Fizz is really good against Zed, so there would be no point banning out Zed again.
Yeah, I gave him his own little counterpick, hoping that if he got rid of the Zed ban, that Sushi might take it.
Yeah, it's possible.
But, three for three, lane... Well, this will be the third game, but so far, lane pressure has not won the game.
No. I think it's just going to be blood, and more blood.
Well, and I'm not a huge Lulu player. Like, I've played her in the past, I like her, I enjoy her kit, but she still feels like a support character to me. Like, I don't really know what her 1v1 potential is.
I mean, it can be pretty good. If Soundside makes the mistake of trying to dive, he's going to be in for a real bad time.
Oh, that polymorph's actually going to be really good against the Fizz. I didn't think about that.
Yeah, so
because he can polymorph him right as soon as he dashes in, get the shield on him, and then even when he falls off of the playful trickster, he'll still have picks attached to him, and he can laser off that. So there's really...
Yeah, they really kind of nerfed... Lulu's ability to play like a strong mid lane when they changed her Q, so I don't think both lasers can hit anymore.
No, I'm pretty sure it is just one laser.
So that really nerfed her ability to really be a powerhouse, so I'm surprised she picked this. Maybe he's hoping just polymorphing and queuing over and over again will be enough.
Or maybe he is just looking to do sort of the Victor strategy of throw the laser down the lane, clear the creeps, and push it in.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe he's just going to try and push in. We'll see. I do think Lulu's lacking a little bit right now. So I think, once again, Soundside's going to have the advantage.
All right, skins. Dragon, Trainer Lulu, and Angler.
Angler?
Fizz.
You mean Atlantic?
Yeah, what? No, the one that... The raincoat. Damn, Void. And Pool Party. Alright, I'm done.
Alright.
I went 3-for-6.
You've gone worse and worse as the night's gone on.
I give up. I didn't even know Void. Void Fizz was a skin.
So. Okay, so Sushi going Chalice.
I mean, the Chalice didn't work great for him last time.
No, it didn't. But, I mean, at the same time...
Did he actually pick more damaging runes? Yeah, he's got 20 ability power this time instead of the 15 that he had before, so he did go a little bit more damage-heavy runes and masteries.
Welcome to the Howling
That's
Abyss.
That's good damage from both of them. Both of them chunked out about the same.
I don't think the Fizz was expecting to take that much damage.
No, I'm actually surprised that did that much.
I do like that he went for the Sheen right away, though. It definitely gives him some burst potential that he's going to need against the Lulu.
Yeah, but he's going to be a lot lower on sustain, though.
Oh, he's going to have pretty much none.
And he's going to have no mana regen. Oh.
Yeah, those lasers are definitely not anything to ignore.
No. I
think... You already double leveled them.
Yeah. I don't... At this point, I don't know how Soundside's going to win this with just Sheen. I don't think he's going to last very long. He can go for the all-in, but I don't know if that's going to be enough.
Well, and with the way Sushi can play it, I don't even know how many opportunities Soundside's going to have to
get... if he gets a couple more of those in, he'll be okay. But he's got to run. He can't take this free damage.
I don't know how...
He's dead.
Yeah, I was just about to say, I don't know how...
After he got in that one poke, he needed to get the fuck out, because he was not able to do anything after that trickster was down. But that's how the cookie crumbles. We'll see how they decide to adjust for game four.
So, I wasn't expecting Fizz to drop that heavily, but no HP, no sustain.
Okay, welcome to game four. Sushi Man is currently up one game on Soundside. Last two games have been a little more one-sided than the first game, so we'll see if Soundside has learned anything from his previous two games and can adjust to possibly pull out a win here.
And this is what I was hoping for. I was hoping that someone was going to pick more of a sustained champion and just go for wave clear, try to play back. And it's funny that Sushi Man actually changed his bands to Ari, Akali, Alistair.
I already have my hands in my face because I saw it. I hate him. I hate him so much.
Going to play the Aatrox, which is why he scooted his bands over one.
So he scooted over his bands over one, so instead of Aatrox, it's Ari, Akali, Alistair, so he could play Aatrox.
And I do like the Morgana pickup into this matchup, because... Yeah. It's Morgana. You drop the pool, you walk away, the creeps are gonna die, you know you're fine.
And he's pretty much only got a spell shield the knock up, right?
That's all I'd use it for, yeah. Unless he feels he needs to do it
for the slow.
Well, I think that's the only other thing that he can spell shield. The actual damage from the slow is just AD.
Everything's physical. Everything Aatrox has is physical, so...
I think the only thing he can block is the knock up and the slow.
So if Soundside was hoping for an AP matchup to make use of the Morgana, not gonna be great. But I don't know, it's gonna be tricky, because Sushi Man can just jump on him and all in, and I think he's gonna try and look for that, much like the Riven game he had earlier, just to all in Soundside early right away.
But I mean, Soundside isn't going to ignite, so I don't expect him to try to be going for the kill. I think his plan is just to clear out waves.
Maybe,
push it
into play
tower.
Safe. Yeah, because then the other thing is, especially he can hold his binding for any time Sushi Man walks up to him too to try and harass him. So as long as he holds his binding for that and doesn't try to get any,
uses it purely defensively for the binding.
If he uses his binding purely for defense. I think he'll be in a much better spot. And then what he should do is he should max his pool so that way he has the best pushing power.
What do you think... Oh, well, I mean, I was going to ask what do you think Aatrox is going to do for items, but he's definitely going to do Guardian Tamer.
That's what I would do, but I don't know. Sushi's a crazy man. He might...
I mean, I don't see him doing the three-blade stack like he did with the Riven.
He could, because Aatrox actually has passive lifesteal.
On his W, yeah.
So, I mean, I could very easily see him still doing that, still going for more of an aggressive build like that, especially if he's planning on just doing a full all-in in the Soundside and not make it a drawn-out game of sustain, because Soundside will probably win that.
Alright, skin call. I want Cookie Baker Morgana. I don't care what Aatrox gives. I just
want to. Pretty sure he doesn't have that.
I know he doesn't, and it's going to disappoint me, but that is the best Morgana.
And I haven't seen Aatrox in so long that I have no idea what possible skins Aatrox has.
He's got that holy one where he looks like an angel, the Justicar, I think it's called. And then I'm pretty sure he's got Mecha.
I know Doesn't... I thought Jax had just the car.
Mecha!
Mecha and Exiled Morgana.
I do like the Mecha skins, because they remind me of the Pacific Rim movie.
Oh, yeah.
And anything anime or mech-related is a win for me.
Yeah. I think they're coming out with Pacific Rim 2 at some point, I thought. But I don't
remember. Immediately, Soundside asks, didn't you ban him? No, he scooted his bans over one so you could play the Aatrox.
Yep. Oh, he bought AP items. What?
What?
Is he going for a cheese for the final win?
Is that a...
He's just gonna fucking Blades of Torment to win.
But...
Oh my god.
I don't...
He's got 86 AP.
But
his E does. The blades that come out in a triangle.
Oh.
That has AP scaling.
170 damage.
Yeah. Soundside has no idea that that's what he's doing.
He has no idea. This is going to hurt.
But he is maxing pool like I thought. Oh my god, this is gonna be
That's the only way for him to play it. I thought Aatrox was just pure damage. I didn't think he even had AP ratio.
No, he's the only thing that has an AP. I don't know why Aatrox needs a rework.
And so it's probably a 1-to-1.
We'll see if Soundside notices when he gets hit by that. Oh, that is not pleasant.
Well, and the Aatrox is going to be able to see us for days.
Oh, that's interesting. I didn't know Soundside opted for no pots, just assuming he's going to get by on the lifesteal with his
which
W.
Which isn't a bad...
Which makes sense. No, yeah. It makes sense. It's doing okay for him right now.
He's really strong. He just has to walk up now. You can drop it so that it hits both the casters and the minions, which he really needs to work.
Yeah, but I think he's too afraid because he thinks Sushi's going to jump on him, but he doesn't realize that Sushi's AP yet.
And that he's not going to be able to do anything besides the slow.
Correct. Sushi, I think, might have had a better chance not going AP, so I think he's just goofing around this game since he has a game to spare right now.
Well, I mean, the nice thing for Soundside is he doesn't have to fight the Aatrox. He just puts his pool down, make sure he gets a CS, can't afford to be missing him like he did those three.
Right. Actually, this is one where I think Soundside now does need to go in for a kill at some point.
But he can definitely wait till level 6.
And he was a little slow on the...
Oh, nice. The minion damage!
Is he going to get...
Is he going to get his pool?
Does he have W to get... Oh, he didn't do it far enough.
Threw it out far enough.
That wouldn't have killed him, though.
If he had dropped him in it...
No, because Aatrox still has his passive. But it would have been nice to get that out of the way pre-level 6.
Well, Aatrox still has his Flash Ignite, too, so...
Oh, and Soundside doesn't have Exhaust anymore. Oh, he used that pre...
And he's...
That wasn't a good idea. I'm surprised she didn't decide to go in on that.
Yeah, I mean, he's just gonna sit back now. He doesn't really have enough mana regen to keep throwing out the Qs aggressively. Especially if he's using the pool to keep himself sustained.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's level 6 now. See, because if he had gotten Sushi's passive off him in the previous fight, he would be able to all in him at level 6 right here.
Yep.
But because he didn't, even if he didn't all in level 6, the only thing he'd do is get Sushi's passive.
Get the passive now. Man, he really just needed to throw the W a little bit further. I think he was worried that Sushi was going to turn and come back out of the bush, so he just wanted to get what damage he could and walk away. Oof. He's falling further and further behind on the CS, though.
Oh, yeah. He's almost an entire wave behind at this point.
Well, he's just dropping the W. He's not getting any auto attacks off, and...
Yeah, he's playing a little too scared.
Well, it might just be that he doesn't know how to play against the Aatrox. Aatrox isn't really one of those characters that a lot of people play anymore.
Yeah, that's true. Also, I still don't think he realizes that he's going AP. I think if he realized, he'd be playing a little bit more aggressively.
Oh, yeah. So the reason he went AP is because the Blades of Torment has a 60% AP ratio, and his ultimate, Massacre, actually has a 100% AP ratio.
Oh, does it really?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
So I don't know how that actually converts over to what the magic damage is, because the tooltip doesn't say. Oh, there you go. No. So, yeah, his Massacre is going to do an extra 89 damage.
Yeah.
Which isn't insignificant when, you know, the character's only
a nice little
1,000 apiece.
Oh, nice. He spell shielded the knockup that time. That was really good. Now he's got the advantage.
Yeah, I mean, luckily that Guardian Orb's given him enough mana regen where he's able to sustain his way through the lanes. He's still a little bit down on CS, but I mean, if he keeps getting this pool on both portions of the creeps.
Yeah, remember when I said I wanted to see them go up to 100?
Change your mind? Now the Morgana's in a really bad spot because she can't even fight over her own relics.
Right.
And her sustain's good, but those E's are doing a lot of damage.
He's just going in for the kill right there. Oh!
Did he?
Oh, he lost his passive.
I mean, that's about as much as Soundside could hope for, but he's still rocking about 200 HP.
If he had his Q up right there, he probably could have worn off that.
Yeah, I don't know how he's going to come back from it. If he, unless he gets
Get the kill! Oh, he got it! What? Oh, he got a little too crazy. Got a little too hypey there.
That was impressive. I'm glad he got that Q off.
That went from 0 to 100 real fast. Real fast. All right.
Jason, did it go to 0 to 100 real quick?
Real quick. Sonic fast. Sonic speed. Sonic. All right. We'll see you in game 5. Jax Warwick Zen. Oh!
Oh,
he just went serious mode. He's winning this.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, my God.
He is not losing to Kyle.
Oh boy, welcome to game 5. Woo. I did not think we were going to make it here, but Kyle's pulled out all the stops. Kyle being Soundside, I don't know why all of a sudden I've said Kyle.
And by stops, you mean tower hugging like a bitch and just letting Sushi dive.
Listen, you got to do what you got to do to survive, and that's how you get to the finals in this game. You know?
And, I was thinking, you know, pocket pick, Sushi doesn't want to lose the Soundside. He's going to come out with the asshole. I'm glad he did. And his bands are fantastic.
His bands were tailor-made to Southside. Jax, Warwick, and Zen.
All three of Southside's, you know, pocket melee bruisers.
Yeah.
The Karma's going to be a terrible pick into the
Yasuo. Oh, it's going to be horrendous.
He's going to get murdered.
Unless maybe he goes, like, tank?
I mean, he would have
no,
to.
No, you can't
that's
do that.
Not,
he's,
that's
he still
not
can't
something
do that.
That he's going to do ahead of time.
But what if he might want to max tether then?
He's going to have to max W to make his way through this game because anytime he throws out a Q, the Yasuo is going to block it. Sushi is very good with getting his wind wall up.
Yeah, I imagine he's going to hold that Q, his wind wall for every Q that comes his way.
Well, and the worst part about it is even if Soundside does manage to land a Q, you know, get it past the wind wall and get it to the Yasuo.
Yeah.
His passive wind shield is going to take up the first hit.
That's
he's
true.
Not going to get damage across onto the Yasuo running.
Yeah, he's gonna have to play that
Q.
Yeah, he's gonna have to play that really good. He's gonna have to make sure he tries to auto to get rid of the Yasuo passive. And then honestly I think maxing W is gonna be his best bet, but even then that's gonna be hard because Sushi can just the second he gets W can just E back through the minions and run away.
Or just go hard onto him.
Yeah.
I mean, normally the best thing about the tether is someone's trying to get away from you or trying to come into you, and so you're doing that kite, 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 kite. Mm-hmm. But if you use it aggressively, it gives the person the ability to turn on you.
Yeah. But since he doesn't have Ignite, Soundside might be able to get off some really good mantra tethers to heal himself up.
I'm thinking traditional skin karma.
Oh, it's definitely going to be traditional skin karma.
I don't know about the Yasuo yet. Maybe Blood Moon?
You think Hainu? Wait, does Yasuo have Blood Moon?
Yeah. Yasuo has Blood Moon, but I don't know. I mean, let's put it this way. All of my skin calls have just been which skin I like the most.
I know. But you're right, Southside is going to do traditional karma. Because three of us believe traditional karma is the best karma skin.
That's because we committed to karma back when karma was shit.
I mean, she wasn't shit, she had some cool stuff.
She had cool stuff.
She had the mantra cone instead of the Q, which would heal herself.
It was goofy.
And then she had the mantra shield, which AoE sped up her entire team. What else did she have?
Oh, there's Blood Moon, there's Mecha, or Project Skin.
I don't think he's going to do Project. And then there's Hainu. I think he's going to do Blood Moon. That's where he's going.
I'm thinking Hainu. But yeah, I feel like this match is definitely in Sushi's favor. And I think he's going to be a little bit more focused than he was in the last match.
Yeah, you don't think he's going to tower dive twice?
I don't think he's going to tower dive twice, and I don't think he's going to, you know, build a cheese build.
You don't think he's going to go AP Yasuo?
No.
Oh.
I mean, I could be wrong. Oh, that bastard.
What an asshole.
He did Lotus?
He did Lotus.
He betrayed us. He's going to lose. That's why he's going to lose. He didn't do traditional. He betrayed us.
Yep, that's the sole reason.
That's what we're calling out right now, because it's a fact.
Okay, we got Guardian. No, don't go Chalice! Don't go Chalice! Sell that right now! No! Don't! He's locked on the base!
Oh. So, the karma is squishy.
Oh, squish, man.
Please don't walk into the bush. Please don't walk into the bush.
I can't believe you went Chalice.
And I would just like to point out that not only did he go Chalice, but he's only got about 680 HP and 26 armor. Which I'm pretty sure Yasuo's passive armor pen is gonna get passed already. Oh, never mind, he doesn't have an armor pen book up. He's only got the 4%.
He is not gonna play this game.
Yeah, I mean, the Yasuo's tankier, he has more damage, he's going to be able to counterplay a lot.
Yep.
It's going to be hard. And I think the only reason the Soundside built the Chalice is because he was hoping he'd be able to throw out a lot more Qs, but that's not going to help against the wind wall.
No, it's not.
And really, when Qs come across, if Sushi's reactions are good enough, he can just E through a minion and get away from it.
Oh, man. He's getting hit by every single tornado, too.
Well, I mean, the hard thing about those tornadoes is they're pretty damn fast. I mean, yeah. You throw it out and it pretty much hits.
That's true.
Ooh, finally! Got rid of the passive.
Yeah. He did that in the original level 3 exchange as well, so he's keeping that in mind at least. That was good. Oh, I like that. Can you get the Q or no? Oh, nice. He even got the Q. Wow, that was a really good. Really good trade.
Really well played. Maybe he's a better karma than we think he is. But yeah, yep. he can't use his Qs to pop that shield because it's not getting any damage across.
Oh, if he had gotten that off, that would be really good. Well, he can keep doing his mantra Qs up until the point where he starts getting lower, and then they'll need to do mantra Ws. Snuck in the,
That was a nice move by Sushi to get the relic.
Yep. Oh, he's trying to not let Soundside get the minions by walling off his Q, but it didn't work.
I mean, that's another thing Sushi could do, is he doesn't even have to use the wall for himself. He can use the wall just to waste any Q that he sees come across.
Right.
It's going for
to
him
make
or
it
minions.
Harder for the... Yeah, to make it harder for the... to make it harder for him to see us, yeah.
I mean, he's already got an entire wave and a half advantage now.
Wave and a half?
Yeah.
How big is six to you?
Six? Oh, whatever.
Literally read, wave.
Dyslexia, I read 12. Whatever. Leave me alone.
Oh, man. Alright, let's see. Oh, that was good. That was good. Nice. Keep going.
Ooh,
keep on him.
Snap.
You got Ignite on him. Oh, he didn't commit to it.
He did not have Ignite on him.
Of course, now that Sushi's six, those knockups are going to get a lot scarier.
Yeah, because the next knockup Sushi gets where he has his passive up, he's probably going to all in the karma.
Yep, he's going to do an exhaust alt, and it's going to hurt. So I'm really hoping that Soundside holds his mantra for hopefully a shield for when he gets knocked out.
I mean, he's doing a really good job of not staying in orthodox positions.
Yeah.
Like, he's doing a good job of dodging, he's doing a good job of actually walking up when you would normally expect a karma to walk away.
Right. Yeah, he's doing a lot better than I imagined. This is a really hard matchup, I think, for Karma, and he's doing a really good job of not getting absolutely crushed.
And he's doing a great job of keeping the W on to sort of limit...
That was a big mistake right there. I think if Sushi had exhausted right there, he could have ended up with a kill, but I guess he didn't want to risk it.
Well, I mean, his ult's only got... What is it, like an 80-second timer?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Soundside's also... He keeps queuing and then going in for the W. He's got to do the W first. Because once he gets the W holding him still... Oh, there goes the exhaust. He missed his Q. That would have been pretty devastating if he hit that Q. Soundside's got to play super safe. He can't do anything right now until... the rocks come up, because
well,
there's no way even if he goes for the mantra Q, he's not gonna live long enough.
Well, and I was expecting him to put another point into his W for the life
the heal.
Regen,
yeah.
But he put another one into his shield, which isn't bad. I mean, they both do about the same amount, but
right.
I'd like to have that HP back.
Yeah, now he's about 10 CS down. I think unless Sushi makes a very large mistake, I think he's kind of got this in the bag right now.
Oh yeah, because he can definitely keep pushing this into tower. I mean, he won't want to because he doesn't want to have the tower dive again like he did the other game.
Right.
But he's never going to have a problem getting CS.
Oh, this is the end.
Unless... Ooh, the shield.
Oh, just barely. Oh, but he had a Mantra Q. If he had Mantra W right there, he would have been in a much better spot. Because he would have got a lot more sustain
that
up.
To end the game.
Yeah.
Barely.
But he can just E. If Soundside gets anywhere near or close, he can just E to him. Oh, he doesn't flash up either, so that's okay. Neither of them have flash up. Soundside has his ult. His Ignite.
I was gonna say, he always has his ult. What are you talking about? He's definitely gotta start using his mantra on his W, though.
To get the health back? Yeah, absolutely.
He needs his HP back. He can't afford to
If he had done that for a couple more of those mantras, he would probably be in a much better spot than he is right now, because...
I mean, the nice thing about Karma's passive is every time he does land an auto-attack or get his W onto the Osmo, he does get his Q back a little bit faster, but that's not going to help him if he's dead.
I don't know. Oh! Oof. Nice dodge. Excellent dodge. He needed that really badly. He took a risk trying to get that CS.
He's down 10 CS.
Yeah, he's still down about 10.
Those passives are blocking pretty much every Q that he does actually get to land.
Yeah. He's gonna mantra up now. If he mantra E's... What's the cooldown on the mantra?
The mantra is only like 8 to 11 seconds, I think. Every time you land a Q or an auto attack, it goes down by a second or 2 seconds.
He really needs to get like a mantra E, mantra W combo so he can sustain and then...
Ooh, snap.
That is the end.
And he has gotten his ultimate back up.
There are the GGs. It was a good series, excellent series, 5-game series. Good try sound side. Excellent second place
Sushi.
Contender, bringing it up to game 2. And congratulations to Sushi, our winner of the League of Legends Salt City Tournament.
Which is weird, because Salt sort of goes with Sushi, but only if it's in soy sauce.
So it definitely goes with Sushi.
Not just pure salt.
Absolutely. Good night.